Kevin Kittle has asked us how to paint the flesh of an Ogroid Thaumaturge, and there's a number of different colours of flesh on this miniature, but to do it, what you should do is start out with the blue parts of the flesh. So today we're going to show you how to paint that part. Now the ideal undercoat for this miniature, for this colour scheme, is McCrag Blue Spray, which you can see is exactly what I've sprayed my miniature with. And then what we need first of all is Cantor Blue for all of its flesh, followed by Norn Oil to start creating the darker areas. Then to highlight it, we're going to need Rust Grey first of all, followed by Fenrisian Grey, and finally Ulthuan Grey. But we're going to be starting out with Cantor Blue, which I'm going to be applying using my large base brush. And what you want to do is, as always, use your palette to get your paint ready. Thin down a little bit more than normal, so it's nice and thin. You're looking to get to about that kind of consistency there, like that. And then make sure your brush isn't overloaded. But what you want to do with this first step is paint this entirely over your model. And you just want one coat here, so a bit of that McCrag Blue still shows through on the edges. Once you've finished applying that base coat, you're ready to start painting on some Norn Oil, and we're going to be applying a few coats of this, and the first one is over quite a lot of the miniature. You want to bring it around towards the front of the body, up to around about this point here, and then cover the back of it, all down the arms, all down the legs as well, and on the tail, go down to around about that point there. Once the Norn Oil is completely dry, we're now ready to apply a second coat, and on the back, this is a little bit further towards the back of it. So you can see this way, I'm building up a transition from lighter blue to the world's darker blue at the back here. But also be sure to go all the way down the arms once more and down the legs as well. With that second coat of shade completely dry, we're now ready to begin highlighting using Rust Grey. And I'm going to do two steps for this. First of all, I'm going to dry brush it on with a small dry brush like this, building up the colour towards the front of the chest and just taking it up slowly towards the sigils and just starting to highlight them with this like this, very softly and lightly. And I'm going to leave the ones on the back darker. So you can see I'm getting lighter towards the front here and darker towards the back. Now I'm also going to be applying a finer highlight of it using a small layer brush, and this is going to be for the muscles, such as just down here, where I'm going to apply a fine highlight following along all the tops of the sharpest ridges and creases in the flesh. I've finished applying that colour now, and you can see I also dry brushed it onto the tip of the tail. And with that done, we're ready to move on to the next colour, which is Fenrisian Grey. Now again, we've got two stages here, and the first one is to dry brush it towards the front of the body, carrying on to build that light colour towards the front of the chest like this. So you can see here I'm getting a nice transition now, building up from the light colour towards the darker colour at the back. And then for the second step of Fenrisian Grey, apply a thinned down coat with a medium layer brush onto the flats of the muscles just to really smooth them off. And then finish off that blue flesh with a fine highlight of Ulthuan Grey, always focusing on the lighter parts of the muscle towards the front. With that highlight applied, we now have the completed blue skin, and you can see I've also highlighted the face to complete that detail along at the same time as well. And with that done, well, the blue skin is finished. So Kevin, I really hope that helps you out when you're painting your Ogroid Thaumaturge, and we'll see you all again soon.